Our motto is to make sure that you need to have in-depth knowledge about the subject before you are entering into it. So let's discuss about CAT and quantitative aptitude, which is very useful in IBPS, SSC, RRB and most of the other competitive exams. So the major questions which eat our brain when we think about CAT as a career are: what are the entrance exams, whether MBA is best or PGDM is best, what will be the fee structure, is it affordable? So majority of us drop here, and also we confuse about what are the bank loans, what are the colleges, and then exam pattern, what is the eligibility, what is the criteria, and what is the syllabus we have to mug up, and some tips. So by this end of the video, I'll be very sure that you will have no confusion about it. So everything from here, your brain will be short and sweetly spoon feeding by our videos. MBA is a postgraduate course consisting of PGABM and PGDM. ABM is Agri Business Management, specifically for agriculture students, and PGDM, Postgraduate and Diplomatic Management. It is of general MBA. All the final year students and UGC completed students can join from there. Coming to the institutes, IIM Ahmedabad always tops the list, and there were around 29 IIMs in India. Likewise, IRMA, MANAGE, NIAM, VAMNICOM, NAM, IIPM, etc. If you get seats in these particulars, in IIM your fees will be up to 20 lakhs, IRMA 12 lakhs, MANAGE 8 to 12 lakhs, NIAM, VAMNICOM, NAM, IIPM all were up to 8 to 10 lakhs. No issues friends, you will be given bank loans up to 80 to 100%. By just having your admission card, and that too repayment will be after 1 year of your completion of the course. Finally, you need to have around 6 lakhs you need to handle, and 2.5 lakhs for IRMA, 5 lakhs for MANAGE, and all the others have 4 lakhs. 95 is the percentile required for you to get a call from IIMs. For IRMA, you need to have 85 plus percentile. For MANAGE, you need to have 80 plus percentile. And all the others have 70 plus percentile. These are all of tentative percentiles and could change from year to year. For your knowledge, IRMA is the institute which only holds ABM courses, Agri Business Management, while the remaining could have PGDM and PGABM and vice versa, etc. Coming to the entrance exams, CAT can give admissions to all the institutes below mentioned. Likewise, it can have PGABM and PGDM also. But while you're coming to GSAT, it only have general MBA. Coming to GMAT, GRA can give admissions even in abroads too. Here central and state governments look after the bank loans you need to have in order to study in abroad. MAT hold NAM, VAMNICOM, IIPM, and SNAP exam holds Symbiosis, NIAM, VAMNICOM, NAM, IIPM. Coming to the exam patterns, CAT have 3 categories to study: quantitative aptitude, data interpretation and logical reasoning, verbal ability. Quantitative aptitude has 34 questions. And DILR have 32 questions, verbal ability have 34 questions, out of which MCQs are more, which have negative marks, and 6 to 7 are non-MCQs, which are like fill in the blanks in each of the sectors. MCQs have 3 marks for one correct answer and minus 1 for each wrong answer, and non-MCQs, which are fill in the blanks, have no minus marks. Coming to the eligibility, all the final year students and any aged groups who completed UGC are eligible for CAT. While the admission process, 50% of your CAT score is taken into consideration, plus academics in 10th, plus 2 and UGC graduation courses, plus group discussions, interviews, seminars and internships, all were considered to give you admission in particular colleges. Coming to the syllabus for quantitative aptitude, the order to prepare is arithmetics, algebra, geometry, number system and modern maths. In arithmetics, you will be covering 12 to 16 questions, and the syllabus you need to cover are percentages, averages, mixtures, allegations and solutions, profit and loss, simple and compound interest, time and work, time, speed, interest, miscellaneous. Miscellaneous is something which contain questions of mixed topics. Coming into algebra, you will be covering 8 to 10 questions here. At first, you have to study permutations and combinations here. Then you have to go through the identities, inequalities, quadratic equations, modulus, functions, logarithms, series and sequences. Next you have to come to geometry. In geometry, we will be covering 6 to 8 questions. Angles, triangles, circles, these three constitute trigonometry, and coordinates, mensurations. Next it is the number system. Number system you will be having 2 to 4 questions, and it is the very vast syllabus, so you need to cover at last. Then coming to modern maths. here you will be covering permutations and combinations, which are already covered before you are preparing for algebra, and probability, series and sequences, number of integral solutions. So this is the order you have to prepare. And for your idea, don't get confused over advanced maths. What is advanced maths? Simply algebra and geometry consumes the advanced maths. So coming to the DILR, data interpretation, you will be having tables, pie charts, castlets, bars, line graphs, data sufficiency, etc. In logical reasoning, you will have questions like blade relations, series, proportions, directions, coding and decoding, puzzles, clocks and calendars, which are very interesting and simple, which are of 8th, 9th, 10th and plus 2 standards. And our third thing is verbal ability. Here you have to be mug up with something English, like you will have questions like grammar, syllogisms, jumbled paragraphs, and you need to unjumble it. And importantly, reading comprehensions, analogs, sequence corrections, verbal logics, few of them are mentioned here. So we are going to deal quantitative aptitude first in detail in a student way approach in a very easy way manner. Be in regular update, subscribe to our channel and meet me in Instagram. Thank you friends, signing off, take care, bye bye. Don't forget the name, AR Facts Club.